Hey guys, welcome to Joe Seminara Presents. I'm Joe Seminara. Today we're going to talk about how to win an Oscar. So if you've ever wanted to win an Oscar for your film, I can give you a little bit of advice on where to go. You have made this film or this documentary and you're saying to yourself, you know, maybe I want to go to the 2020 awards or some type of Oscars down in the future. I'm going to win an Oscar for my movie, my best performance, anything that I create. How do I get that 8-pound gold award in my hand? Well, I can tell you that it's just as hard as probably hitting the lottery, but there are some avenues that you can go through, and with a little bit of luck, you yourself may win an Oscar for your movie. So let's talk about the first thing. I mean, so, you know, when you're making a film, everybody always says to themselves, well, boy, it would be great to win an Oscar. How do I get at the Dolby Theater? You know, let me walk down the red carpet with all the other celebrities and everything else like that. But, you know, most people are confused with how that really happens, and it never happens with a knock on the door saying, hey, you just did an incredible picture. You're gonna win this Oscar. Oscar winning takes a lot of nomination votes, it takes a lot of campaigning. You have to go through some of these steps that I'm gonna talk to you about now. And you have to pick a really interesting category. So what category do you think you can win an Oscar in? Well, I mean, let's face it, if you're gonna go after best actor, best film, best director, you're up against some of the heavy hitters, you know? And then this year, you're gonna be up against Martin Scorsese with his Irishman and stuff like that. So you may be saying to yourself, even though that you think your movie is the best, but let's face reality, you're not gonna compete with these people, right? So it all comes down to picking a category that an everyday Joe Schmo can win that doesn't have a few million or $40 million to put together a marketing campaign for you to sort of get in line with that Irishman movie or whatever it is out there. So, you know, even though your film can be excellent, it still doesn't mean that that you're gonna win, because at the end of the day, it is gonna take votes and it's gonna take a lot of marketing behind it. A lot of people don't know that that's how you get to win an Oscar. So I do have a friend of mine though who was nominated for a documentary short. I'd probably say that that's your best chance of getting a Oscar, because documentary shorts are, most of the time when themes get selected in that category, it's because there's either violence, tragedy, addiction, world horror, you know, I mean, something really bad will get a documentary, like, you know, maybe working kids in Mexico at the age of 8 years old to make clothing or something like that, or battered women in Pakistan. That's sure as hell gonna get noticed in the eyes of the people who vote on the Oscars. And who votes on the Oscars? Well, I can tell you that there's no one on the Oscar panel that's voting that's probably below 50 years old. I mean, we got some heavy hitters up there. They've been there a while. They know what they want. It's a tight-knit community. It's a very political community as well. You know, I can only imagine what can go on behind closed doors up there. I heard a lot of stories. But, you know, if you go the documentary short way, you might have a fighting chance. And to do that, your film has to have had a theatrical run in either both Los Angeles and New York. So it has to be in the theaters, and you can go to Tug for that. They can help you get it in the theaters, or you can just call an independent film and maybe have it play for like a half hour and stuff like that. I mean, a 7-day run. But, you know, either way, you're going to have to really kick some butt with this. And film festivals, you know, you want to be recognized in the film festivals. So which ones are going to be able to put you in line of winning an Oscar? Well, it's certainly not going to be the film festival at the local college. You need to be in the top 70 film festivals and have had to have placed in one of those film festivals to be considered. So there's a lot of things to consider when doing this. But, you know, if you stick with a line that's the easiest, lightest path through resistance, you can definitely maybe get your film in the Oscars. And then it's the marketing, it's the campaigning. A lot of these big name actors fell short with Oscars just because they couldn't bring the level of awareness up. That's kind of crazy, right? You say to yourself, here it is, I'm gonna make this film. And it's hard to make a film, number one, especially for an independent director, right? So you've gotten your film funded. Now you mean to tell me that you gotta spend X amount of dollars to get it in, you know, to win an Oscar? Yeah, because that's the same bull crap that happens in this industry with the major, major motion Hollywood production studios where, you know, they have $100, $200, $300 million to put into marketing. How do you think they get the word out for people to get the butts in those seats? That's really how to do it. If you have a lot of money in this industry and you strategically align your marketing, you're going to do very well in the movie business because it's all about creating a film and creating enough marketing. Like I'd say, spend $10,000 on a film and spend $10 million on the marketing. That's really the way it is. Because if you can convince the masses to go see that movie, just like the Blair Witch Project did. I mean, that was an incredible picture. Everybody remembers it. But it was only X amount of dollars, which is very low to produce it. I did know the number at one point, I forgot it. But it was like nothing to produce it, but the marketing, the incredible amounts of marketing and the money that was put behind it to get the people into the theaters and to rent it and everything else. So you wanna go through the path of least resistance on this one, but look, I hope I see you at the Oscars, especially in 2020. I'd love to see an independent film up there. You know, they always throw maybe every now and again a student film of that, and that's just to satisfy all the political garble. But if I was running the Oscars, my friends, it would be ran right, and we would do it right. But I'm not hanging out with that sort of crew because I like to be who I am every day. And the reality is, I hope that you can get up there, at least you can get some exposure. Remember, if you're gonna spend any money making a film and to be considered for the Oscars, put the money in the editing, because even when you're doing a documentary short, it's all about the concept idea, right? So let's say it's about dying animals in the rainforest or something like that. You can go there with your handheld camera as long as you're getting good footage. And I don't mean like crafted, artful, cinematic footage, but you know, footage that you can clearly see it visible and everything else. You should really put the money to the editing, because the editing is where it kind of puts it together. And there's famous editors that have won their documentary shorts and Oscars that there's a list a mile long, maybe contact them. And they obviously know what won. So thank you for joining this fun-filled episode of Joe Seminara Presents. I hope to really see you at the Oscars. And remember, you can't make anything or apply for anything in this industry unless you've actually made your picture, unless you've made your stuff. So stop what you're doing, go out there, make the movie, and I hope to see you at the Oscars.